Well, Mr. Speaker, under this Prime Minister, sexual misconduct at the highest levels in our Canadian forces continues unchecked. Serious allegations are ignored, investigations are shut down, critical evidence is lost, and charges are dropped. Those who are complicit through their actions or their silence remain in senior positions. This government's consistent failure to act begins and ends with this Prime Minister. What did the Prime Minister know, and when did he know it?
Honourable Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, I've answered that question a number of times, but we have demonstrated since forming government that we take extraordinarily seriously the responsibility to make sure that people are protected in their places of work, in their service to their country, and that we've brought forward mechanisms and measures that continue to protect them. We recognize there need to be more resources. We need recognize there needs to be more work to end the culture, a culture that tolerates far too often inappropriate behaviour. We will continue to move faster and stronger on exactly this issue.
Honourable Member for Aurora Oak Ridges, Richmond Hill.
This Prime Minister is defiant that he has consistently got it right for the men and women in uniform, but he failed to have General Vance suspended or allegations against him investigated. Still, he approved a salary increase of $50,000 for him. He approved a replacement chief of the defense staff who also stands accused of sexual misconduct. And he continues to support a defense minister who has failed in his sworn duties. When will the Prime Minister hold senior officers accountable, starting with the defense minister?
Honourable Prime Minister.
We have no tolerance for any form of sexual misconduct. When such allegations are brought forward, we always take them seriously and forward them to the appropriate authorities. That is exactly what happened in this situation. The Canadian Armed Forces have launched an independent investigation on this matter. In regards to the pay increases, decisions on salary increases are made entirely by professional public servants, and we respond to the recommendations of those public servants.